Let's take up AS-04 now, Accounting Standard 4. Okay, now contingencies and events occurring after balance sheet date. Contingencies, actually, they have given the name of Accounting Standard 4, but later on when they issued Accounting Standard 29, they covered contingencies in that chapter and they removed it from here. So tomorrow we'll do AS-29 and we'll cover contingencies. Today we are here only covering events occurring after the balance sheet date. Okay, now why do you need events occurring after balance sheet date or a standard on that? Now, see, balance sheet is prepared up to 31st March. Balance sheet is signed somewhere later, maybe 1 or 2 months later, 3 months later. So suppose we sign balance sheet in May. Okay, so there is a 2 month gap between the balance sheet date and the signing date. Okay, now there might be certain events which are material which might occur between the balance sheet date and the balance sheet signing date. Now, these events, the standard says that some of these events would be adjusting events, means you go back and adjust your balance sheet. Some of these events would be non-adjusting events, that means you just disclose it, or it might not even require disclosures. So it depends upon what type of event it is. It just says that you take caution of making note of all the events that happen between these two dates, and then you decide whether I should go and adjust the balance sheet or not, or I should disclose the event or not. The point here is, event is occurring between balance sheet date and signing date, but it relates to something which has happened or something existing before the balance sheet date. I'll give you examples. Okay, event occurring after balance sheet date is significant events, whether favorable or unfavorable, both, that occur between balance sheet date and the date on which financial statements are approved, which is in the board meeting or when it is signed. Okay, two types of events can be identified. One, which provide further evidence of conditions which were existing as on balance sheet date. The second one is, which are indicative of conditions that arose subsequently. I'll repeat. One event is which will confirm or which relates to a condition which is existing as on 31st March or before 31st March. And the second event is which the conditions arose after 31st March. Now, the conditions which arose after 31st March are normally considered as non-adjusting event. Maximum you might be required to disclose those events. However, conditions that existed before 31st March but were confirmed after 31st March, or events occurred after 31st March, those events are generally considered as adjusting events. I'll give you examples for each of them. Just a pictorial thing of what we discussed. There's a start of reporting period, which is 1st of April. There's end of reporting period, which is 31st of March. Then there's a period during which, or there's a date on which the financial statements are signed. Then the information is made public, that means annual reports is published. And then you have an AGM sort of. These are the normal dates. Now we are only discussing, or AS4 only covers 31st March to date of signing of the balance sheet. It does not cover anything happens after that or anything happened before that. It is only specifically covering 31st March to date of signing of balance sheet. Okay, as I said, there are two types of events, adjusting event, non-adjusting event. Adjusting event requires appropriate adjustment in financial statements. Non-adjusting event just requires disclosures through report of approving authority. That means it might be in your director's report, or it might be in your trustee report or some other report. It just requires disclosures. It does not require any adjustments. Now, when I say adjustments, adjustments might be required anywhere, whether assets, liabilities, expense, income, capital fund are required for events occurring after the balance sheet date that provide additional information materially affecting the determination of amounts relating to conditions existing on the balance sheet date. So adjusting events only relate to those conditions that are existing as on 31st March. So what are the requirements? First is, event should occur before the balance sheet date. Between the balance sheet date and the approval date or signing date. It should provide additional information regarding a condition that existed as on 31st March. As I said, let's take some examples. A loss on trade receivable account, that means you have a debtor standing in your balance sheet. Okay. That debtor is bad, becomes bad, which is confirmed by insolvency. So the customer becomes insolvent, that insolvency occurs after the balance sheet date. Now what is the event? Event is insolvency of customer. That insolvency event occurred between the balance sheet date and the balance sheet signing date. But the condition, that means he was my debtor, and the condition, that means, okay, what is the condition in this case that existed as on balance sheet date? Sorry? He was not officially insolvent, but we doubted, or we had a doubt that he would pay, and we created a provision for doubtful debts. Okay. That means, only if we had created a provision for doubtful debt and later on we came to know that he has become insolvent, then and then only we should go back and adjust our accounts and we should make it a bad debt and not provision for bad debt. If there was no provision for bad debt for that customer, then the condition was not existing as on balance sheet date and hence adjustment is not required. If the amount of bad debt is material, then we can give it as a disclosure in the notes. But we should not go back and adjust our accounts. Is it clear what is a condition existing as on balance sheet date? I'll write it down for you. I have a debtor of 1,000 rupees. Okay, 31st March, I feel that he will not be making me the payment, or I have some doubts क्योंकि बहुत time हो गया अभी तक pay नहीं कर रहा है मुझे लग नहीं रहा है कि वो pay करेगा. I have doubts about it. So what I do is I create a provision for bad debts. Say suppose I create a provision for 60%. This is my balance sheet as on 31st March. Okay. My signing date is somewhere in May. Okay. So say 27th April, I come to know that he has become insolvent or he has filed for insolvency. Now because he has filed for insolvency, I know that I will not recover any money from him. Right? Now, was there a condition existing as on balance sheet date? I had doubts. So that was a condition existing as on balance sheet date. The condition got confirmed on 27th April when he filed for insolvency. Hence, what I should do, I should go back to 31st March and adjust it with 1000 rupees, make it zero and classify this as bad debt and not provision for bad debts. This is called event occurring after balance sheet date. Suppose I did not have a provision for bad debt here. Okay, this was entirely 1000 rupees appearing in my balance sheet. That means I had no doubts regarding recoverability of that amount. If I had no doubts about recoverability of the amount and on 27th April I come to know that he has become insolvent, this is not an adjusting event. Okay, then I can't go back and adjust my accounts.
Sir, is it,
then
is
I have
it,
to, one second, let me complete. Then I have to first decide whether this 1000 rupees is material. If 1000 rupees is material, then I just have to disclose that the receivable of 1000 rupees has become bad in notes to accounts or director's report or somewhere. I don't go back and adjust my accounts. Yes.
Is it material that how many percentage provision I am making?
How many percentage?
Provision I am making. Suppose 2% provision, it is not material.
See, 2% provision if you have made on the entire receivables. Okay, that means you are not doubting a particular debtor. It is just a normal policy of your institution to provide for the total receivables.
Okay.
Then it is not an adjusting event. Adjusting event is only when I have a condition that I am doubting that he will not pay. So 2% to main baki sab pe create karta hi hu, iske upar I create an excess provision of say 30%.
Then only adjustment.
Then only it is an adjusting event. अदरवाइज तो कोई भी डेटर इंसॉल्वेंट हुआ, I have to go back and adjust. That's not the case. Because 2% तो जनरल पॉलिसी है, मैं सब पे ही कर देता हूँ, राइट?
एक्सेप्शनल
हाँ, एक्सेप्शनल केसेस ओनली. अनदर एग्जाम्पल, अ फ्रॉड ड्यूरिंग द अकाउंटिंग पीरियड. फ्रॉड हो गया अप्रैल टू मार्च के बीच में, बट आई डिटेक्टेड इट आफ्टर 31st March. सो सपोज 27th April इज द डेट वेन आई कम टू नो कि यार लास्ट ईयर में कुछ फ्रॉड हुआ था. Now, was there a condition existing as on balance sheet date? Yes, fraud to pehle hua hai. Fraud pehle hua is a condition existing as on balance sheet date. Event ka kya hua? Event is detection of fraud. Event has occurred after balance sheet date, but condition of fraud was happened before balance sheet date. Hence, I have to go back and adjust my accounts for the fraud. अगर फ्रॉड होता 1st of April को एंड डिटेक्शन होता 27th April को, इज देयर अ कंडीशन एग्जिस्टिंग एज ऑन बैलेंस शीट डेट? नो. देन आई विल नॉट गो एंड एडजस्ट माय बुक्स.
कंटिंजेंसीज आर व्हाट वी हैव टू मेक सम एडजस्टमेंट और समथिंग.
यू आर नॉट मेकिंग अ प्रोविजन फॉर ऑडिट रेम्युनरेशन?
या समटाइम्स वी विल मेक दैट.
ओके, सो सपोज How will an auditor remuneration come in event occurring after balance sheet date? Suppose I made a provision of 30,000 rupees for auditor's remuneration. Okay, on 27th of April or some other date, I realized that no, it is not 30,000. Actual approval was 35,000. Or I have revised the auditor's remuneration to 35,000. Suppose, backdated. So that is an event occurring after balance sheet date because condition was existing. That means auditor's remuneration I had to pay in the last year. So I'll go back and make it 35,000.
How about in case of CAG's remuneration?
Sorry?
CAG.
CAG. CAG remuneration.
How we have to treat that? Because
CAG remuneration, okay, what happens? What are the event existing or condition existing on the balance sheet date?
For example, what will happen? First, statutory auditors, they will finalize the...
Right. Statutory auditor will finalize, right.
And afterwards, CAGs will come and the event will occur. That means that...
Do you make a provision for CAG fees?
Yeah, sometimes.
So you just are required to make, see, that provisions will cover in AS-29. This is only events which are occurring after balance sheet date and for which I have to go and adjust. See, audit, I know that audits will happen for every year. So I have to anyways make provision for those audit fees. Whether it is normal audit or CAG audit or... Yes. Reporting date is 1st April to 31st March. 31st March becomes reporting date. See, reporting date ka definition hota hai, date on which you report. That means you prepare the balance sheet. That is 31st March. Signing date is date on which auditors sign. So, event occurring after balance sheet date is between the date of balance sheet and the date when the auditor sign or the balance sheet is signed.
But in our case, mein toh, jaise CAG audit mein, CAG gives the report. And certificate, but उसके बीच में we are not able to do all these things. हमारे इसमें तो
आपका normal audit होता है? Normal audit होता ही नहीं. अच्छा balance sheet sign होता है?
Balance sheet audit.
Balance sheet sign होता है?
Balance sheet sign.
What is the date when balance sheet is signed?
Balance sheet date sign जो हमारा जो है जो institute से जाता है, we have to prepare it before 30th June.
30th June. So your event occurring after balance sheet date is between 31st March and 30th June.
So हमारे लिए that would be
April, May, June is the period when you have to think about this standard.
November में आता है.
नहीं, it is not about audit. वो CAG आके balance sheet sign नहीं करते. Balance sheet sign होता है 30th June को. CAG आके audit करके जाते हैं.
That will be considered as the.
Yes, for you that will be considered as signing date. So 30th June, April, 1st April to 30th June is the event occurring after balance sheet date.
A small thing I want to clear. Suppose on April I came to know one debtor has become insolvent. But debtor has become insolvent actually in March.
March.
I have not made any provision. In that case, what
you have to go and adjust.
Adjust.
So I'll repeat his question. He says that I have a debtor of 1,000 rupees. That debtor becomes insolvent in March, but I come to know in April. Okay, so event is I come to know that he has become insolvent in April. Condition is he had become insolvent on 31st of March. So you go back and adjust, make it a bad debt. Okay. So there is a case study which you have to answer. A Limited has agreed in principle to sell a plot of land on 18th March 2012 at a price determined by an independent valuer. Pending the agreement for sale and due to non-receipt of valuer's report, the sale of land could not be completed up to 31st March. The company or the institute received a report on 7th of April 2012 and the agreement was signed on 10th of April 2012. The financial statements were approved on 12th of May 2012. Is this an adjusting event? Yes, the conditions were existing. You had entered into an agreement. You know that you have sold it. You have sold the land before 31st March. It was only that the price was not confirmed. Hence, it is a condition existing as on balance sheet date. You go back and make the transaction or record the transaction at the proper price. So, it is an event occurring after balance sheet date. Hence, adjusting event and company should record the sale in the books as on 31st March. Okay, any examples you have on adjusting event? Any questions you have whether this is an adjusting event or not? Okay, non-adjusting event. Non-adjusting event is any event where adjustments are not appropriate because conditions were not existing on the balance sheet date. It is only to be disclosed through approving authorities report, like director's report. Example, you have certain investments and the investments value go down after 31st of March. Now, the investment value has gone down after 31st March. Hence, it is a condition which was created after 31st of March. So, you don't go back and revalue your investments at the lower value. The investments will still be valued as on 31st of March only. You will not go back and adjust it. Ordinary fluctuations do not relate to condition existing at the balance sheet date and hence you do not adjust. Okay. Another example of non-adjusting event is an announcement after the balance sheet date but before approval of financial statements that you want to discontinue an operation. Now, when you want to discontinue a part of operation, say I will not conduct this course or I will not do this. This happened after 31st March. Hence, it is not an adjusting event. Non-adjusting event, you only have to disclose in a director's report or your trustee report or some report of approving authority. You have to disclose nature of event and the estimate of financial effect of the event. Where estimate cannot be made, the report should state that estimate cannot be made and it should give nature of the event. Okay, now, an earthquake destroyed a major warehouse or maybe a building on 20th April 2012. Last accounting year was 31st March. Accounts were approved on 8th May. Is this an adjusting event? No. Condition did not exist as on 31st March, hence it is a non-adjusting event. Hence, the construction of warehouse is non-adjusting event. Okay, X company limited theft of cash rupees 5 lakhs by cashier in January 2012. It was detected in May 2012. The accounts of company were not yet approved by the board of directors of the company. Whether the theft of cash has to be adjusted in the accounts of the company for 31st March? Yes. Condition was existing as on 31st March, hence you should go back and adjust it. So again, I will repeat, event should occur between the balance sheet date and the date of approval. Adjusting event is an event when condition was existing as on balance sheet date, then you have to go and adjust the accounts. Non-adjusting event, if conditions are not existing on the balance sheet date, you don't go back and adjust, only disclose the requirements. Okay, a few MCQs, multiple choice questions. Event occurring after balance sheet date are events favorable or unfavorable which occur between? Which of the choices? You have a doubt in the MCQ? One second, I'll come to your doubt. One second, let us answer this MCQ, then I'll come to your doubt. It is second number because board meeting date is the date when you sign the balance sheet. So it is between balance sheet and the date of board meeting. Okay, yes sir, your doubt.
It is very clear, amount should be made after 31st March only. Amount should be released for the period of January to 31st March. What is the treatment for the DA arrears?
When do you come to know about the DA?
But balance sheet is not signed June 30th only.
And you come to know about the amount before 30th June?
No, we don't know the DA percentage. DA percentage we know.
You will know before 30th of June?
30th of June, yes. What is the treatment for that DA arrears?
Okay, so the question is that the DA for Jan to March is paid in April or May or somewhere after 31st March. The amount is also known after 31st March, but it is known before the date of signing of balance sheet. Am I correct?
Yes.
Yes. Then you should go back and adjust your books.
No, create
a liability as on 31st
order
of March.
Order is very clearly says, order, government order is clearly saying, you should not be paid before 31st March.
It is about payment, it is not about accrual. I am not saying go back and pay before 31st of March. I am saying create a liability before 31st of March. Okay, what happens to bonus? When do you come to know about the bonus? In the middle of the financial year, before signing of balance sheet or not?
Yes,
after signing of the balance sheet. Okay, do you make a provision for bonus? Yes, that is on estimate basis. Yes. Now, because you come to know about the final amount after signing, you can't go back and adjust because balance sheet is signed. Suppose in a particular year, if you come to know about the final amount before signing, you go back and change the provision for bonus and make it a final amount. Clear? Okay. Which of the following are adjusting events as per accounting standard 4? Which of the four? One. Answer is one only if you created a provision before 31st March. Otherwise, none of the above. Clear? Answer is one if you created a provision before 31st of March. Otherwise, answer is none of the above. So, both the answers is correct with some conditions. Second and third is wrong. Second is what? A decline in market value after balance sheet date, you cannot go and adjust. Third is a fire in factory after balance sheet date, hence it is not an adjusting event. Clear?